Hello everyone, here's Duke SP, Rodovaldo, and well, few guys and few people have been asking me how to test UNAPI TCP-IP MSX application, basically Internet MSX-DOS applications, because OpenMSX does not emulate that, and not everyone has an MSX with an Ethernet or a Wi-Fi adapter like Obsonet, DanielNet, GreatNet, SMX has a built-in Wi-Fi adapter and the future access Wi-Fi. So how to do that? Because sometimes we just show the applications and people say, oh, okay, I want to test that, but I just run MSX through emulator. In fact, you can test that through blueMSX. blueMSX emulate Obsonet, and there is a short comment, in fact two short comments. The first one is the Obsonet emulation is not perfect, so UDP applications will not work very well, but most applications are TCP/IP anyway, so this is not a problem. You can test Telnet, FTP, and a lot of other applications. The second short comment is Obsonet. I'm not saying it's bad, but the worst internet adapter for MSX of all. And why is worse? Because it was the first one. It's basically just the Ethernet stack, so just the connection to the network. All the TCP/IP protocol stuff is done through a driver that was made by Canadian Nestor Soriano, that is internationalized. The TCP/IP stack is not really lightweight, because there is a lot of processing needed to sort packets and everything else. So you can imagine it that Z80 processor that is old is not really fast to process the TCP stack and other applications. This is why we have DanielNet, GreatNet, and other adapters that are accelerated. So they have the TCP/IP stack done on hardware. It's way faster. In case of GreatNet or SMX Wi-Fi, it's 10 times faster than Obsonet. So do not judge performance based on this emulation, because Obsonet is not as fast as the other options. You can get up to 35, 40, even sometimes 50 kilobytes per second performance with GreatNet or excess Wi-Fi adapter. Okay, so let's see how to do that. There is this package I'm making available, everyone can download. You just extract it. The link to this package will be in the video description. Okay. And there you go. Here we have. And we have install instructions here, basic install instructions. I will walk through. First one is for Windows 10, Windows 7, Vista, some other Windows, DirectX 9 runtime is not available. BlueMSX use DirectX 9, so you might need to install DirectX web setup.exe. I am not going to do that in this machine because it has already been installed, so, but it's pretty simple. I do not need to walk you through that. Second step, install BlueMSX full version. If you already have BlueMSX, you do not need to do that. If you do not have, just let it install. I was going to make a mistake. For most Windows versions, you need to run as an administrator, otherwise it will not work. So you right click and choose run as administrator. And let's do it. So let's just install. And so blueMSX has been already installed now. Let's close. Next step, you need to install npcat. Npcat is the application that will allow you to share your network adapter with blueMSX. So let's just install. And I tend to use this legacy. I'm not sure if blueMSX uses it or not, but anyway, it's good to have it installed. It's really quick to install as well. And it's done. And let's click finish. Now, there is a blueMSX folder from the package. Let's copy this to your root folder. So, there we go. It's here, blueMSX. Now, you have here some ROMs and a disk image. That's fine, okay? Next step is, let's go back to the package. You will call the MSX Trouble Error UNAPI TCP-IP folder to the blue MSX installation folder, machines folder. It's the C program files, blue MSX, machines. You just paste it here. And let's continue. That's fine. So here is the information from the machine we are going to use. Pretty nice. Okay, now there's a step here. We have the blueMSX desktop icon. For Windows, Vista, and newer, you might need admin rights because blueMSX was meant to run in Windows XP and it will not function perfectly if you do not do that. So, to achieve that, right-click the desktop icon, properties, go to compatibility tab, and run this program in compatibility mode for Windows XP Service Pack 3. Okay. This is the best for blueMSX. Okay. Now, we will open blueMSX. Since it's a Windows XP application, you receive a warning because it has admin rights, okay? So what you are going to do now is you go to Options, Ethernet Interface. There is only one option here that has an IP address. This is the network card of the machine. You choose that, okay? The next one, let's go to Options, Emulation. You are going to choose MSX Trouble Error UNAPI TCP-IP. Okay. Let's turn it on. Now, click HD in the ID to Sunrise Primary. We are going to insert the disk image. That this image I have done is a red head for UNAPI. So it's in blueMSX folder, disk and DSK. We just choose that. And now let's reboot. No need, it has already booted, but anyway, let's reboot. And you see, this is a machine that already has an ID hard drive. It has installed Ethernet UNAPI from Konami Main, that is Internet Store Live. We can just type mode 80. And in here, you can see I have left a VI pre-installed Telnet and MSX Hub. So you can just go to hub, for instance, and type hub categories, and then I can just type hub list games, and that's all the games you have from MSX hub. I can, for instance, install game hub install X Racing. It's getting, as you can see, it's about 2 to 3 kilobytes per second, not really fast, but that's Obsonet, okay? And so basically MSX Hub is installing that ROM file. You probably will need software ROM to run that. You can install through MSX Hub as well. Okay. Or you can just go to Telnet. Let's go to Telnet. Oops. Keyboard. Yeah, well, this keyboard is in Portuguese, and basically I need to figure out, okay, so, sorry about that, okay. There we go. Down that, and the best. Let's try Satan MSX, the DS.R and port 23. Oops, and there we have Satan MSX VBS working really fine. Okay guys, so pretty simple, right? And if you already have blueMSX installed, you can just skip the installation and start from step 3, install npcat on. It's pretty simple. This disk image makes it a lot easier. I have already done all the configurations, you already have a hard drive. And it's pretty easy to get a grasp, or like I do when I'm developing my UNAPI applications, I use blueMSX to debug. Okay, that's pretty much it. Thank you very much. Hope you enjoy.